We continue in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of God the Father, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Good afternoon, everyone. And welcome to our liturgy, welcome to our Mass, as we come together. Once again, I welcome all of you who are here with me in church. I welcome those of you who are joining us this afternoon from your home, wherever you may find yourselves. You're all very, very welcome. To prepare ourselves then for the Mass, let's once again bring ourselves into the presence of a God who loves us deeply. Let's acknowledge our sins to God, asking for forgiveness, asking God also. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
Denounce him.
All those who were my friends are on the watch for any misstep of mine. Perhaps he will be trapped, then we can prevail and take our vengeance on him. But the Lord is with me, like a mighty champion. My persecutors will stumble, they will not triumph. In their failure, they will be put to utter shame, to lasting, unforgettable confusion. O Lord of hosts, you who test the just, who probe mind and heart, let me witness the vengeance you take on them. For to you I have entrusted my cause. Sing to the Lord, praise the Lord, for he has rescued the life of the poor from the power of the wicked. The word of the Lord.
from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to the 12, "Fear no one. Nothing is concealed that will not be revealed, nor secret that will not be known. But I say to you, in the darkness, speak in the light. What you hear whispered, proclaim on the housetops. And do not be afraid of those who kill the body, but cannot kill the soul. Rather, be afraid of the one who can destroy both soul and body in Gehenna. Are not two sparrows sold for a small coin? Yet not one of them falls to the ground without your Father's knowledge. Even all the hairs of your head are counted. So do not be afraid. You are worth more than many sparrows. Everyone who acknowledges me before others, I will acknowledge before my Heavenly Father. But whoever denies me before others, I will deny before my Heavenly Father." My friends, the Gospel of the Lord. Father Jim Willig was a dynamic priest of the Archdiocese of Cincinnati, Ohio, who died at the age of 50 from kidney cancer. He couldn't understand why God would take him when he was at the height of his ministry, turning the lives of so many towards God. He suffered greatly, but he didn't waste the opportunity within that suffering. He co-authored a wonderful book, actually, entitled Lessons from the School of Suffering. Lessons from the School of Suffering. And it was published just, I believe, it was 2 months before his death. Although Father Jim didn't understand the why of what was happening to him, he trusted that there was a reason, a greater plan. He would often say, "I don't know what my future holds, but I do know who holds my future." And with that conviction, Father Jim got the strength he needed day by day until he went home to God on Sunday, June 24, 2001. He embraced the challenge of each day, leaving the future in God's hands. The prophet Jeremiah, whom we met today, whom we meet in today's first reading, must have felt pretty much the same. He had just had an altercation with the priest Asher, who had Jeremiah scourged and placed in the stocks for prophesying the destruction of Jerusalem. While acknowledging the animosity that was leveled against him, Jeremiah was also aware of the presence of God with him, like a mighty champion, as he put it in today's reading. Jeremiah didn't know what the future held, but he certainly knew who held the future. Jesus in today's Gospel is addressing the 12. "Fear no one," he advises. And a little later, he reiterates that same message. "So do not be afraid. Even all the hairs of your head have been counted." That's how precious you are to God, he's telling the 12, and all of us by extension. In Paul in today's second reading, while not mentioning fear directly, cites the reason why believers need no longer fear sin and death. It is because of the gracious gift of Jesus Christ, in whose dying and rising
all our fears can be expelled through faith, Paul says. These are difficult, strange, and unprecedented times that we're going through. The past 3 months seems eerily surreal. Is this really happening? I found myself asking in recent months. And yes, it is real. But God is in there with us. We're not alone. Each one of us is precious to God, Jesus reminds us today. Rabbi Herschel said that God is of no importance unless God is of supreme importance. As we face the difficulties, the realities rather that are so difficult right now and causing anxiety and fear, perhaps Father Jim's words serve us then. I don't know what my future holds, but I do know who holds my future. Father Jim believed that. Jeremiah believed that. St. Paul believed that. Do I believe it? I ask myself. What about you? Do you believe those words? I don't know what my future holds, but I do know who holds my future. We profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church, and confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. And I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. The Lord listens to the needy. He is always ready to help. We have only to ask, so let us not seek the compassion of the one who cherishes even the smallest sorrow.
For the church, which dispenses the abundant free gift of divine grace, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who are dealing with COVID-19, the ill, the medical carriers, those working to contain the spread and find a remedy, that the spirit of understanding leads us to consolation and hope. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who are tormented by fear and worry, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all fathers, living and deceased, That God bless them with the abundance we praise to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have come into the presence of our Father, especially our Father, we praise to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Jane McCann and Mary Horlitz, whom we are remembering in a special way in this Eucharist, we praise to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the intentions of the parish prayer line and our own private intentions, we praise to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Loving God of all creation, we commit our cause to you and praise you for caring for us in our need by giving us your own Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Receive, O Lord, the sacrifice of conciliation and praise, and grant that cleansed by its action, we may make offering of a heart pleasing to you through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your heart. And let's give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your Word, through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin, fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so, with the angels and all the saints, we declare your glory, and with one voice we acclaim.
Oh,
these holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring unto the fullness of charity together with Francis, our Pope, Frank, our Bishop, and all your ministers. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your faith. Have mercy on each one of us, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, with Saint Michael the Archangel, and all the saints who have seized you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. The Savior's command and form by divine teaching, we now dare to pray as one. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant our peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. And may the peace of the Lord be with each of you. Let's take a moment again to call to mind anyone in our lives whom we might not be at peace. And let's ask God to help us, even begin the process of coming to peace with that person or with those persons. those of you praying with us from home, we now pray our act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are the blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I long for you in my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. As though you have already come, I embrace you and unite myself entirely to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. By the sacred body and precious blood of your Son, we ask of your mercy, O Lord, that what we celebrate with constant devotion may be our sure pledge of redemption through Christ our Lord. And just a reminder that communion is available for those of you who are at home who wish to come tomorrow morning after the 10 o'clock Mass, from about 11 till 11:20 or thereabouts, and I will be outside under the canopy, and I will distribute Holy Communion to anyone who wishes to receive at that time. And also, printed copies of the bulletin are available at the parish office during the week. You can also view it on the website. How many of you are visiting us? Okay, well, it's wonderful having you join us, thank you for sharing this time of prayer with us. And I'd like to take this opportunity of wishing all our fathers a wonderful and a blessed Father's Day tomorrow, and may it be a wonderful day for all our fathers. And tomorrow, June 21st, 39 years ago, I was ordained to the priesthood back home in Ireland. So, I just question how did that happen? But anyway, one of the things I wrote in the bulletin this weekend is that if we think that we have the Lord of life planned out, God laughs. Because so often the plan that we think, the road, the journey we think we're going to go on, God just laughs. So simply what I wrote. There's also a number of photographs from my journey, and some of you I think are in them. So Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Our Mass is ended. Let's go in peace to love, to serve the Lord. And have a blessed week, everyone. Thanks.
Hear the sweet old far off hymn, the tales.